Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, I will cover most important MCQs for upcoming SSC JEE exam. I only cover the important questions. The kinetic energy due to rotation is equal to its half I omega square. Kinetic energy for rotation and kinetic energy for translation half mv square. So from options half I omega square, B is your correct answer. The lead bed is made of, it should have good damping capacity. Mild steel no, alloy steel also no, pig iron also no, chilled cast iron. It should made up of grey cast iron. Your grey cast iron options not available, chilled cast iron available. You can answer chilled cast iron. Question is, drilling is an example of simple cutting, orthogonal cutting. Orthogonal cutting we can call it as two dimensional cutting, and oblique cutting we can call it as three dimensional cutting. Here drilling an example of oblique cutting. And in case of orthogonal cutting, your broaching and your turning parting operation also your orthogonal cutting option. Broaching and turning parting operation. In a separate, the metal is removed during, it's removed during forward stroke. One more thing is important here. Time of forward stroke is less than the time of return stroke. Sorry, it's opposite. Forward stroke time is greater than the time of return stroke. Because return stroke no use, that's why very quickly it's coming back. Forward stroke only we are doing the metal removal operation. Question is, D'Alembert principle is used for reducing the problem of kinetics to equivalent statics problem. A is your correct answer. In case of pier bending, the beam will bend into an arc of parabola, no, ellipse, no, hyperbola, no, circle. D is your correct answer. For beams in bending, beams are always subjected to bending stress and your direct shear stress. In case of extreme fibers, bending stress is non-zero and direct shear force is zero. In case of extreme fibers. And in case of neutral axis, direct shear stress at neutral axis, it's non-zero and your bending stress is zero. In case of beams in bending, at extreme fiber, bending stress is non-zero, but direct shear stress is zero. And at neutral axis, your direct shear stress is non-zero, bending stress is zero. This is very, very important. And in case of shaft in torsion, shear stress is maximum at the outer fibers and zero at the axis of rotation. Point of contraflexure is the point where bending moment it changes sign. Or zero bending moment and beam changes curvature. All three points are important for point of contraflexure. So here you will get point of contraflexure in case of overhanging beam. Question is, section modulus Z is expressed as, and from our bending formula, sigma B by Y equal to M by I equal to E by R. So here, sigma B equal to M by I into Y, or we can write m by I by y. This I by y is a section modulus z, or we can write it as m by z. To resist sigma b, your z should high. That's why we are taking I section. In railway track, we are using I sections, because I section z is high. It can resist bending stress. So from option I by y is a section modulus. They may ask for circular section. Circular section I equal to pi by 64 d to the power 4. Your y maximum is r or d by 2, you can write. R is radius, d diameter by 2, then I by y will get z equal to pi by 64 d to the power 4 divided by d by 2. Your dq 32, pi by 32, dq is your section modulus for your circular section. Question is, a framed structure is perfect if it contains number equal to, this one they asked in gate also, n equal to or m equal to 2j minus 3, here j replace with n, 2n minus 3. A is your correct answer. Here m is your number of links and n is your number of joints. This is the end of this part. Thank you, friends. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you.